do it better than he can. Really like that, no pretend. Had to get him back just to revenge. I'ma go to Paris for the weekend. I'ma go with it for the weekend. Sports mode, cause I be speeding. No safety, I'm bleeding. I can never fumble like defense. Going hard for my sisters. Hurry up, take my picture. Heels hurt, I got blisters. Touchdown, make me richer. I ain't even hungry, but I ate that. I keep on winning and they hate that. And they hate that. And they hate that. I ain't even hungry, but I ate that. I keep on winning and they hate that. And they hate that. And they hate that. Eat 'em up.
Only religion was the moon. Made a couple million, hallelujah. Daddy was a prostitute. Called a homeschooler. Never did homework. I was gone home with the work, no tutor. Used to have enough. Grew up with the hustlers and the killers. Now I'm kicking it with Puffy in the villa. Chillin', click full of zombies like Thriller. Got real, about to get real. That's just how I'm feeling.
Back in 2003, have a look at the link. Lincoln Financial Field, where 70,000 are rocking and ready to go in Philadelphia. Just a short time ago, these Philly fans in full roar as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. Pyrotechnics ablaze. They're set to go as their Eagles will match up with the Dallas Cowboys. And not much on this one. And look at this. Right away, a loose football. And it's picked up by the Eagles. And his guys. Take over at the 31-yard line. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. The first carry now for Tony Pollard. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
Now a diving effort right side. He's got it. And he's got it. Caught. Touchdown. A great play there. There to make the grab. And the Eagles are on the board here first in the season opener. Get on the extra point. And it's now a 7-0 game. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. And not much on this one. Takes it from the 21. And he tries to get as much as he can here while protecting the football as he dives to the ground. Taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. This is Elliott. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. Back to throw, Saunders. And this throw incomplete. Well, the defender all over him that time, but it's going to lead to third down.
Well, that one was all about the defender making life difficult for the receiver. Very tough for a guy to hold on to the football through all that contact. He ends up forcing the incompletion.
On third down, Saunders. This is Chase Claypool on the receiving end. And he'll go out of bounds right around the 40. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down. Looking to throw, Saunders. He's got a man open. It's Chase Claypool. And he will be knocked down hard, but he will have the first down. Both sides were holding their breath there on that fourth down play, and the offense can breathe a sigh of relief.
And both knew exactly where the first down markers were. You know the defense is trying to guard those sticks and try and keep people in front, but somehow, some way, those guys found a way to pick it up.
A pretty decent gain on the tough run before he's brought down at the 25. 8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. Off the play fake. Saunders. He'll get this out wide here to Elliott. And he'll get it down this time to the 17.
Well, they've certainly done a nice job spreading the ball around on this drive. This time he gets it out to his back, and it's another nice play and another first down. They've got the defense on their heels a little bit. They're reacting instead of being aggressive and making plays.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
Second and 10. Now back to the ground with Elliott. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
No surprise there, Jadeveon Clowney with a tackle for loss. We all know how he became one of the most famous players in football, though, don't we remember?
Oh, that one play.
Yeah, that one big-time play. It was on highlights everywhere. They want to see more of that here in the NFL.
Throw on third down, Saunders. And he's got it, and he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. This is shaping up to be a really nice looking drive to get the season underway here.
And how long do you think that they actually have been plotting this drive? I'm talking about the coaching staff, right? They've been thinking about this for a while now, and I think they're executing it even better than what they expected.
To throw, Saunders, he'll buy some, touchdown Cowboys, a 2-yard touchdown grab, and the Cowboys are an extra point away from tying the football game, extra point right down the middle. And that will tie our score here in this opening quarter of play. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And this will be returned from deep in the end zone. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. And Charles, nothing like squaring off with a division opponent, a division rival in week one. Do you like that they are matching up this early, or would you prefer a game like this be a few weeks down the road?
I actually like the early matchup for a few reasons, Brandon. First of all, it allows you to see that the entire offseason and know, hey, right out of the gate, we're playing a division game. Second part is it spreads them out a little bit. If you just have them all bunched up at the end of the year, that's not as much fun watching teams try to survive that gauntlet when you do have injuries down the stretch. And last but not least, let's face it, we're TV people. What a great game to sell right out of the gate. Someone sharp in this game. I mean, a touchdown pass in the first drive and comes right back, and he's flinging it around really well here.
Really nice throw there to pick up the first down. You kind of just feel a laser focus and confidence about him, and I think we saw that this week, didn't we? Talking to him and the coaches, they felt good about his performance coming up.
Yeah, I was really impressed with that last practice we saw when they went through two-minute drill, when they went through all the different situations. Ball hardly hit the ground, and I thought, yeah, he might be locked in for this one.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. Here's Burrow setting up to throw it. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done.
Time to give some credit to the big fellas, the offensive line here, because you've got to have good protection on crossing routes because you've got to give your receiver time to work all the way across the field. That time, able to scan the field, spot his receiver moving left to right, and make a good, accurate throw. Thank you, guys.
5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. Five yards remain on second down. Burrow will throw. All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked by Kevin Byard. And the Cowboys are going to take over once again with a football at their own 20-yard line. Now, they were in a great position to take the lead, Charles. Obviously, all they needed was a field goal to do that. They wanted the touchdown. Unfortunately, they're going to get neither.
And you know every offense talks about the same thing each week, don't they, Brandon? They want to end every drive with a kick, whether it's a field goal attempt, a point after the touchdown, or at worst, a punt. This time, they had that opportunity but didn't get it. Because you know the field shrinks that close to the end zone, and that allows a defense to tighten up their coverage, and they pick that one off.
Up at the 29 now, they'll head to the line, second and a yard. From the pistol, here's Elliott, and not much, maybe a yard up to the 29. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
And this is going to be a Cowboys first down as the tackle made here at the 36. Well, after an interception, last thing you want to do is go three and out, give the ball right back. They avoided that.
Yeah, you definitely do not want to do that. I remember in college I played with a really big-time player on defense. We ended up getting an interception as we passed the offense coming out. He told him, if you don't take care of this football, you have to answer to me later. You definitely want to take care of it, pick up first downs.
A first down carry by Elliott. And unable to get downhill there as he'll take this up to about the 37. The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. the shotgun again to Elliott, powering his way forward. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. 71 yards rushing for him in this first half as he is looking in mid-season form here in the opener. So after a good run by Zeke, another first and 10. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
And when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game. And we remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll hand things off to the coach, Jonathan Coachman, in Orlando. He'll have a look back at a very intriguing opening weekend in the NFL. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. He'll wind up losing 3. And now it's third down. Looking to throw, Saunders, and going deep for Hill, and that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down. And forthcoming, a field goal try for the Cowboys. This officially a 55-yard attempt. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they stop it prior to what will be an important fourth down. Comes the Cowboys punter, as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt. And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone. Costly.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we got a shot at point.
And got his man complete. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. A big connection on that one. 31 yards. So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. His man complete. It's Morgan. 7 yards, the pick up there. Working with a second and 3. Now it's Burrow. And this one is incomplete.
And I think they'd be well served to take that type of a physical approach against him the rest of the game. He's had his way so far. But on that last one, that worked quite well for the defense.
in need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much since. Again, it's Burrow. Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with 23 seconds to go till halftime. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Play action. It's Burrow. Flushed out right. And this throw a bit late as he couldn't reach back for it.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Here we go. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Play action. He's going to let this one go deep. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
One thing that offensive guys stress when they throw the deep ball, you're just counting on your receiver to find it, adjust before the defensive back can get his head around. In this case, though, the DB matched it move for move and knocked it away.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10.
12.
And Burrow going to throw again. Throwing right, and that's complete. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the second quarter. 14-7. So we reach halftime here at our first Monday Nighter of the season as we get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
Okay, Coach, yeah, adjustments likely going to play a big role in this third quarter in what's been a tight contest so far.
We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half.
Taken in at the 3.
And he'll get it up just past the 20 as these guys will go to work at the 21-yard line. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. Hey, Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little.
Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted.
Picked off at the 48, and his guys are going to take over at their own 48-yard line. Not the way you envision things to start out the third quarter. One play and already a turnover.
It's interesting. You and I were talking with the coach, and he talked about how at halftime, as a play caller, he wanted to make sure he got a new script going for the second half, not just the one that he operated off of to start the game. Nowhere on that script did it have that result.
action here on first down. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. A wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down.
You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now, the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game. This is third and one, very likely four down territory, even if they don't get it, though. Again, it's Elliott. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Elliott running right. Busting through contact. Just wasn't a huge hole there for him to operate. Stopped just inside the 35-yard line. 91 yards for him on the ground now. He has been a tough man to bring down all night. The last run got six. Now second and four. The give is to Elliott. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. A loss on that play, and now third down gets tougher. Third and six. From the gun, Saunders. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Well, that's got to frustrate him a little bit because they nearly got to him there, and it would have been the first sack of the game instead. They're able to influence the release, and they did force the incomplete pass.
And that is no good.
And this score will stay right where it is. Down here in the third quarter, obviously that's one they could have used.
Yeah, and one of my favorite special teams coaches in the NFL told me what separates the kickers in the NFL versus the ones who are not is not the misses. It's the second miss in a row. Best kickers in the league, they don't miss two in a row. He's got to get his head back together in case he gets another shot.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And last time, one play, interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling. Because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in it, and let him fling another one.
So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. Working with a second and four. Burrow going to keep it, running right. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much since. They're passing here, Joe Burrow. And he's got his man. It's the tight end, Goddard. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And not a whole lot there. He does get a couple, taking it from the five down to the three. Two of their three red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second and goal. And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. A big play, if you think about it right now in this season opener. It's third and goal. Now flags come in here. Looked like one of the Eagles might have moved. A bad time for a false start penalty as they're backed up now for third and goal. Now Burrow. This is caught. That pass play good for seven, but it still brings up a fourth and goal. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. The offense is staying out there. Here we go on fourth and goal from the one. Burrow going to keep it on the sneak. Try to wedge his way in there. No signal. I don't think he got there. He didn't. They try the sneak, but not enough push. He doesn't get in. And this Cowboy defense comes up with a goal line stand. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Yeah, a little closer.
Yeah, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
Second and 10, third quarter of the season opener. They go to Elliott again. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. The second down play, not much better than the first, just a gain of one there.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
Third down now. Those last two plays indicative of how things have gone for them. Just nowhere to go on the ground and struggling to put up points. One quarter remains here as we wrap up the week on a Monday night. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. The Cowboys on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is third and 9. Another carry tonight for the workhorse, Elliott. And he'll get this only up to about the 3-yard line. Only a yard of the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a fourth down. Out now comes the Cowboys punter as he'll punt it away for the second time. And he's able to get it out of there, and this is a pretty good kick. Fielded at about the 28. They'll call that a 61-yard punt. He got all of that one. And the Eagles will have it, taking over first and 10. This Philly offense set to go. Their defense got the stop, forced the punt, and now you really start to monitor the clock as they nurse this slim lead. Meanwhile, Burrow's throw here taken in as he's able to find Goddard. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Now Burrow on first down. He delivers another to Goddard, complete.
And he's going to get this down near the 30-yard line. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Here's Burrow. Going down the middle, and it's complete. And finally, down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7.
Well, that should be a reminder defensively, and I think it's a reminder to myself because you just can't sell out to stop the run. There's still enough time that this offense can move the football through the air, even on first and second downs, and they obviously picked the right spot to throw the ball there.
Throwing again, it's Burrow. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. 3 yards the gain there, second down. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to it? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
Pollard is going to go backwards. He'll lose yardage back to the 5. A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, 3rd and goal. Now it's Burrow. And Goddard's got it. Touchdown, Eagles. A 5-yard touchdown catch. And the Eagles are closing in on a winning start to the year as they extend their fourth quarter lead. Gano the extra point, and it's now 21-7. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. And not much on this one. Takes it from the 21. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 30, right about the 29. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got 2nd and 3rd down to fall back on.
Here's 2nd and 10. Operating from the gun, Saunders. Open man completes it to Claypool. He'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Working the sideline there. Good route, good catch. First down, and he gets out of bounds.
Yeah, you have to like the play calling because you have to run some guys down the middle of the field to draw some of the defenders away. They can't just let them guard the sideline exclusively. That's how it's going to work. Sidelines and incompletions to use the clock.
On 1st and 10, Saunders. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. 8 yards to go on 2nd down. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And he'll throw this one away. But I don't think he was out of the pocket. No, here comes the flag. In the pocket, chucked it away. Flag comes down.
So you got to move a little bit, right? Know where you are on the field. Have some awareness. Tackle to tackle. You got to get outside of that tackle box in order to get that done.
So now it's 3rd and long. Because remember, they also lose a down on the grounding call. To throw again. Boy, stays up, and this is going to be incomplete.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts, this time on 3rd down.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on 4th down. They're going for it. Sit down. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. He'll fire deep downfield for Lamb. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Cowboys here unable to convert on fourth down. And the Eagles are going to take over in great field position. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. They'll try and start this drive in the air, eluding the pressure right. Down under 2 minutes to go in this football game. So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10.
11 MT.
Now it looks like he'll throw here. Looking left side, and it's complete. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. He's been a busy man here in this one, and they're showing off some nice footwork to stay in bounds.
And with those types of catches and the volume that we've seen in this game, wouldn't you keep him busy as well?
I would.
Of course. You got to keep throwing it to him. He keeps making plays.
Burrow's throw here, taken in by Morgan. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line.
But when you're up by two scores in the fourth quarter and you're going to throw the football, expect to see a lot of man coverage, because usually what comes along with man coverage is pressure. So if you're a play caller and you want to keep throwing the football, that's fine. Just make sure your offensive line understands they're going to get additional guys running at the quarterback.
And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Tony Pollard, a 10-yard touchdown run. And the Eagles are looking good here in the season opener as they're able to extend their lead. Extra point try good by Gano. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns and 21. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. Very short kick taken right at the 20. And he is out of bounds as they'll start up past the 30. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And they knew coming in that this would be a tough place to go in and win a season opener. But this has just been a performance, to be frank, not to be proud of here as they trail big in this fourth quarter. Looking to throw on second down. Saunders, he's going to let it fly. Is this intercepted? It is. It's intercepted. Picked up by Anthony Brown. And the Eagles will have the football as this is taken up past the 30. That, Charles, the first interception he's thrown here in year number two.
And I know it's just the first one, but didn't it feel like what we saw from him last year, where he was plagued by this type of a play? And they thought that, you know, over the offseason, going into a second season, some of that would go away. Thus far, still looks a lot like his rookie year.
And he'll work this one up to about the 38. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3. They'll go again with Sanders. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. From the gun on third down is Burrow. He finds his man complete. That's Morgan. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open. Just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
And the timing a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground.
They're still throwing the football here, and obviously the incompletion stops the clock. That's a bad thing.
Feels to me like they're just keeping them honest on defense, because you know they're going to stack the line of scrimmage and try and stop any type of a running play. Short little passes may work in exchange of running plays. Keep the clock moving, keep them moving.
I guess you're right. If they can get some first downs, just as good as running the football. Now they go play action now. Burrow, flush to his right. He finds his man complete. It's Morgan. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. A big play there with his first career touchdown in his first career game. And the Eagles able to push further out in front. Gano the extra point. And that will increase their lead to 28. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. It's a squibber picked up around the 27.
Here we go, here we go.
So fly, Eagles fly. It's a victory for Philadelphia. And they were buoyed, Charles, by a big second half that put this one on ice.
So you get the sense that whatever was said at halftime obviously hit home. I think it's a little bit more than that, though. Obviously, there are words that are said, and, hey, come on, guys, we have to play better. But sometimes it's just sharpening your execution.